who shoots and a save by Chirkov, who will hold on. Chirkov has made some unbelievable saves here. No, it's still held in. Pass across and they score! Number 19, Logan Ehrlich. And it's cleared out by the Generals with 5 seconds left. And they are going to win this hockey game here, folks.
Expectations were higher than ever as the Washington Lee Generals hockey program entered its 10th year. The 2016-17 edition featured seven seniors, including last season's first-team all-CSHL goaltender Carson Chirkup. Captains Ben Stanley, Spencer Brown, and Peter Harvey returned, as well as fellow seniors Francis Penny, Sarah Brown, and Carlos Wilson. Following them, a bevy of players with a wealth of experience from the previous campaign. Kayla Ehrlich, John Petrich, and Theo Vargas entered their third year with the club, along with blue liners Will Schmidt, Jeffrey Henderson, and Connor McCormick. Ned Huffman, fresh off a breakout sophomore season, was back as well. Six sophomores, including standout forward Logan Ehrlich and defenseman Jack Stanley, were joined by fellow classmates Andrew Robinson, Max Lusting, Cooper Motzko, and goalie Matthew McKnight. Three freshmen would make their debuts, forwards Hunter Spicer and Will Harvey, and goalie Eli Constantine. Good evening, everyone. I'm Neil Sika, and I'm back once again to recap the 2016-17 season of your Washington Lee Generals Hockey Club. The Generals opened their season by hosting divisional opponent W.T. Woodson. Carson Chirkup and Eli Constantine were both solid as they split the duties in net. A couple of goals by Ned Huffman and another by Peter Harvey gave the Generals a 3-2 lead midway through the game. From there, it was the Brown siblings, Spencer and Sarah, who combined for three more tallies to complete the 6-3 win. In Game 2, WL hosted the always formidable Hayfield Hawks. The Generals started well as Huffman and Ben Stanley propelled WL to a 2-0 lead early. However, the Hawks roared back with two late goals in the first, then added three more in the second to take a commanding lead. Huffman would tally again, but that wouldn't be enough to climb any closer as the Hawks' 5-3 victory put the Generals at 1-1. WL looked to bounce back the following week against West Springfield. Freshman goalie Eli Constantine earned his first start in net and was spectacular. He stopped 26 of 27 shots as the Generals rolled to a 6-1 win. Logan Ehrlich and John Petrich scored first period goals to give the Generals an early lead. In the second period, freshman Hunter Spicer set up Ehrlich twice on the same shift as Ehrlich buried the puck past the goalie both times to complete his hat trick. Jack Stanley and Francis Penny rounded out the scoring as the Generals cruised to their second win of the season. T.C. Williams was the next opponent on the schedule. Logan Ehrlich continued his scoring terror with another hat trick, and goals by Francis Penny and Will Harvey gave the Generals what appeared to be a comfortable 5-1 lead midway through the second. However, a mix of penalties and loss of focus by WL allowed T.C. Williams to claw their way back into the game, ultimately erasing a 4-goal deficit to tie it up at 5. The tie would prove to be an important lesson down the road for WL. The next week, the Generals faced off against the reigning 2-time league champion West Potomac. Chirkup did his best to stall the high-powered Wolverine offense. After a scoreless first period, the defending champs were able to score twice to jump out to a 2-0 lead. Ben Stanley's power play goal gave the Generals some life midway through, but West Poe was ultimately too much to handle on this night. George Mason Edison was next up on the schedule. The Generals entered their last game before the winter break. Solid defense and better overall team play helped the Generals control the game from the onset. Constantine, in just the second start of his young career, pitched the shutout, turning away all 16 shots he faced. Goals by Logan Ehrlich, Spencer Brown, and Hunter Spicer, along with a pair from Ben Stanley, provided the offense as WL earned their third win of the season. The Washington Post, in their 2016-17 ice hockey preview, highlighted the January 6th matchup between two-time defending champion West Potomac and Washington Lee as one of their games to watch. And boy, was it ever. West Potomac entered the contest with a record of 7-0. They were on a 17-game win streak dating back to last season. West Post scored less than 2 minutes into the game, but it was evident early on the Generals weren't going away as they challenged the Wolverines all over the ice. A well-executed game plan by the defensemen and wingers John Petrich, Sarah Brown, Kayla Ehrlich, and Cooper Motzko bottled up the neutral zone and slowed down the Wolverines' high-octane offense. Hunter Spicer's goal in the final minute of the first period knotted the game up at one goal apiece and gave the Generals momentum. Midway through the second period, Ben Stanley tallied to give the Generals the lead. Then he added another in the third to extend it 3-1. West Potomac's frantic push in the final minutes resulted in a score with 1:38 remaining. But a lockdown defense and great goaltending by freshman Eli Constantine helped the Generals close out the game strong. Constantine stopped 32 of 34 shots in a breakout performance as the Generals upset the Wolverines 3-2. WL and George Mason Edison faced off for a second time in a Thursday night tilt at Kettler Capital's Iceplex. WL fell behind on an early goal before Spencer Brown tied the game in the second period. The Generals dominated puck possession and would ultimately outshoot their opponent 41-8. But amazing goaltending by Mason had WL trailing 2-1 with just 3 minutes remaining. The Generals never panicked. In dramatic fashion, they tallied three times in the final 2.5 minutes. First, Cooper Motzko tied the game. Then with 29 seconds left, Hunter Spicer found the back of the net to give WL their first lead. Spencer Brown's empty netter in the waning seconds capped the remarkable comeback. The Generals had won their third game in a row. The following night, the Generals traveled to Prince William Ice Center to take on the Titans of T.C. Williams for the second time. This time, the Generals remained focused and determined. They dominated once again, racking up 39 shots. But just like the previous night, they found themselves up against strong goaltending. A goal by Ben Stanley and two by Ned Huffman provided the offense, while Constantine continued his stonewalling of the opposition, stopping 21 of 22 shots. The Generals rattled off another win to improve to 6-2-1 and extend that streak to 4 games in a row. In the final game of the regular season in the CSHL, the Generals hit the road to Mount Vernon to play W.T. Woodson. While Stanley brothers Jack and Ben each scored early goals, the Generals found themselves down 4-2 to an inspired Woodson team at the end of the first period. At the start of the second period, Constantine took over the reins in net and shut down the Woodson attack. Ben Stanley and Ned Huffman scored goals to even the game, and the Generals carried the momentum into the third period, tallying twice more on goals by McCormick and Motzko. Woodson would add a late goal, but the Generals were able to close out the game, completing the comeback and winning 6-5. With a 5-game win streak, that earned the Generals the number 2 seed out of the North Division, finishing 7-2-1 through 10 games. In the quarterfinals, they were paired against the South Division's number 3 seed in the CSHL playoffs, the Lake Braddock Bruins. The Bruins boasted several highly talented scorers and averaged over 5 goals a game. Ben Stanley and Spencer Brown tallied first period goals as WL jumped out to a 2-0 lead before the Bruins scored in the final minute of the first. Lake Braddock carried the momentum into the second, eventually evening the game at 2 goals apiece. Midway through the second, Chirkup was forced out of action with an injury. Freshman goalie Eli Constantine stepped in and played well with the new surroundings. The two teams traded goals before entering the third period, knotted at 3. Lake Braddock took the lead with 6 minutes to play in the game. As the final minutes wound down, the Generals' frantic attack paid off when Ned Huffman received a pass in the slot from Ben Stanley and buried it past the Bruins goalie for the equalizer. With the game tied at 4 at the end of regulation, a shootout would determine which team advanced to the Final Four. Unfortunately, Lake Braddock capitalized on their chances, eliminating the Generals from the playoffs. The Bruins would move on. The shootout loss stung the team, who had expectations of making a deep run in postseason play and challenging for a league title. However, with CSHL play over, it was time to regroup and set their sights on their arch rival, Yorktown. In front of a standing room only crowd at the Kettler Capitals Iceplex, Washington Lee and Yorktown celebrated their senior nights with plenty of pomp and circumstance before dropping the puck to their annual season finale. Led by the seniors, the Generals started strong as they sustained early pressure on their rivals. John Petrich's goal midway through the period broke the ice, and Logan Ehrlich tallied to give the Generals a 2-0 lead. In the second period, several penalties by WL gave Yorktown's power play enough chances to cut into the deficit. However, goalie Carson Chirkup stood strong in net, turning away several scoring chances. WL killed the penalties and maintained their two-goal advantage as they entered the final period. The Generals' defense was stout, bottling up Yorktown's offense for most of the game. A fortuitous rebound led to a Patriots goal with just over 2 minutes left. Desperately trying to even the game, Yorktown pulled their goalie for the extra attacker. Fans were on their feet cheering on the respective teams as the seconds ticked away. Chirkup turned away several shots and his teammates challenged every loose puck as the Generals were able to cancel out the Patriots' final push. One final faceoff of the neutral zone with just 3 seconds remaining in the game had Spencer Brown knock the puck away to safety as the final buzzer sounded. Final score, Washington Lee 2, Yorktown 1. The Generals' victory over Yorktown was a culminating win, not just for this team or this senior class, but for the entire program and all the current and former players, alumni, fans, and supporters who have helped it build over the last decade. For the 7 seniors, the win was an exclamation point to the end of a great high school hockey career. And as the senior class turns their focus to the next chapter in their lives, WL Hockey will look for a new set of leaders to emerge and carry the mantle forward. And now, it is my honor to introduce to you the 2016-17 edition of your Washington Lee Generals.
Hey, brother, there's an endless road to rediscover. Hey, sister, know the water's sweet, but blood is thicker. Oh, if the sky comes falling down for you, there's nothing in this world I wouldn't do. We'll be right back.